We just experienced a devastating RV tire blowout in the middle of Canada, resulting in the destruction of our trailer brakes and the loss of our freshwater holding tank supply. Now, rather than waiting weeks or months for an unreliable RV service center, we're here today to guide you through a step-by-step process of how we efficiently and effortlessly fixed everything. We will also share valuable and common RV services that are often overlooked for quick RV repairs. By the end of this video, you will learn how to break down a disaster such as an RV blowout into simple and manageable repairs. Additionally, we promise that we will share the final cost of all of our repairs, allowing you to decide whether it's worth your time. For reference, our repairs were completed in just one day compared to months awaiting at an RV center. Let's get started. So there's a lot of moving pieces today. Went and got the oil change, so that is checked off the list. As Nay and I like to joke around and say, one crisis at a time. I was able to call around this morning and talk to quite a few people, some tire shops locally, and some recommendations they had to get the trailer brakes addressed. Unfortunately, they were 2 weeks out from being able to get anyone in for servicing on the mechanical side of things. So they gave me some references to call out and reach out to. I did make connection with somebody here locally. They said they'll take us in around 1 o'clock, and that's exactly what we're gonna head out and do right now. Whew, it feels good to just get one thing checked off the list and then move on to the next. I'm excited that someone's able to sneak us in with some brakes because listen, we already have the spare tire on. We can move the RV, but we can't necessarily stop the RV right now. So let's get that addressed.
We're gonna roll out a white horse with like brand spanking new. We're gonna have clean sheets. We're gonna have clean underwear, trailer brakes, new tire, oil change. I mean, we're gonna be brand new Hanks.
I love that. Come on up here with that good energy. Get on in here, brand new Hanks. I can dig it.
So many of you commented last week asking if we had a TPMS or why it didn't warn us before the blowout. We believe when this occurred, our tire was a little underinflated, but not enough to warn us of low pressure. With that and the uneven wearing we've been noticing, it was a recipe for disaster. Could it be that we ran over something that caused the sudden blow? We can only speculate on what caused this and take the experience and go forward inspecting our tires more diligently. If the blowout had been from overinflation, we probably would have gotten a warning. A TPMS is a much needed tool to have on the road, but never rely on these products 100% to keep you safe.
If you enjoy this video so far, make sure you subscribe. It's absolutely free and it guarantees that you'll see our new videos every Thursday when we release them. Thank you guys so much for all your love and support. We couldn't do any of this without you. So the game plan is, we made the RV park aware that we're gonna pick up and go, head out for a couple hours and then come back to the site. They said they're all good with that. You can leave your stuff here at the site as well. So I'm just gonna unhook the sewer, unhook the water, just leave it because I don't wanna deal with putting it all away and then dragging it all back out. You gotta make things easy on yourself when you're going through the crises. One last thing I forgot to update you guys on, as far as the tire situation, it is good to call around for pricing and availability of those tires. We made a couple different calls to other dealerships and we landed on one, Integra Tire. They're first come, first serve. It's kind of like Les Schwab in California or Discount Tire, so to speak, in America. Plan is, get a good night's sleep, wake up super early and be at their doorstep 7:30 a.m. So get it in, get it out, because I want to continue editing. Unfortunately, all this mayhem landed on our editing days and wow, there's a lot of moving pieces right now. Just trying to balance it all at one time. That's all you can do. Whew. Just breathe.
So I'm thinking when we come back to this campsite, we're just gonna stay hitched up. And then before we go to bed, we'll just put all the slides in. So that way when we get up in the morning, which will be like 6:30, we're not waking your neighbors. Just something to think about if you guys are in a similar situation, which we try to respect our neighbors around us as much as we can. It's also gonna be easier for us in the morning if we could just wake up, put our pants on, and head out the door.
Now don't get us wrong. Most tire shops are able to assist with simple fixes. However, for more complex jobs, like the soldering of trailer brakes, it may take longer for the dedicated department to schedule an appointment. This happened in our situation, and it's highly worth considering alternative options. What we did was we just asked the tire shop if they could recommend any local companies specializing in this particular task. Lo and behold, Local Welding Industries can be a valuable resource in this regard. They have the expertise to be able to handle tasks like soldering the trailer brake wiring, and they often have more flexibility in scheduling due to lower demand compared to typical tire shops. Other things you might not have thought that welding industries could help with is assistance with brakes, framework, axles, and much more.
All right, so the update.
What's going on,
Carl? We've been driving without trailer brakes this entire time. 200 miles, no trailer brakes. Even just that light we were at, where we kind of had to slam on the brakes and stop. Yeah,
really?
we didn't have trailer brakes the whole time. He said when that got ripped off, that was the corresponding piece to send signal to the other side of the trailer.
Holy
so,
cow.
Yeah, so we didn't have trailer brakes.
Wow.
The one thing he did say is the piece of the braking system retracted back into the brake itself, so they're gonna have to take the wheel off, get in there, rewire it,
so that
it can get integrated back normally.
Is this something that'll take a long time?
Probably an hour or two. He also said our bushings were wearing a little weird too. Like the actual axle hangers, you know, they were kind of wearing odd, so. He said he doesn't feel like it needs to be addressed a second, but he said down the road, definitely keep an eye on it.
Okay.
Now here's the catch. In order to fix the trailer brake wiring, the entire wheel needed to be disassembled because the wiring had actually retracted into the brake drum. Inside the drum is a large magnet that controls the trailer brake through an electrical connection. When this wiring is disrupted, the magnet is unable to receive a signal and therefore fails to engage the brake. Initially, our technician claimed that we had lost brakes altogether, but I have some doubts. After doing some research, I discovered that most trailer brake wiring runs in a parallel, meaning that the left side of the trailer has separate braking from the right side of the trailer. Now, if we truly experience a complete brake loss, it would indicate that the brakes are wired in a series connection, which means there is a connection between both sides of the trailer. This would be super unsafe because losing brakes on one side would result in losing brakes on the other side as well. Now, we would love to hear from you if you have any expertise on trailer brakes. Comment below and help teach us more about this. That way everyone else watching can learn as well. Despite this, the trailer brakes were successfully rewired and now function flawlessly. It is important to note that whenever a tire change or wheel work is done, it is super crucial to recheck the lug nuts within 60 miles or 100 kilometers to ensure that they're properly tightened. All in all, a huge shout out to this place, Jacob's Industries here in Whitehorse. If you ever have any trailer braking issues or anything that's like deep and mechanical that you need fixed that goes beyond the scope of like a tire shop could handle, get this place a call. They squeezed us in immediately and they did an amazing job. All within an hour and a half, I would say we were here. I love good quality service.
A little damage.
I didn't realize you were done.
I know. I think we got snuck in here on accident because they had so many other customers. Like they were telling customers, we can't take you in. And he's like, he took me in to check me out. He's like, huh, snuck right in here, didn't you? I'm like, I don't know. They told me to show up at one. He was like so nice about it. 153 buckaroos. That's Canadian dollars, by the way. So we got trailer brakes. We are safe again. Look out, everyone. The Hanks are okay to be back on the road.
That's kind of scary that we went that far without trailer brakes.
Listen, I know, but I'm only human. What can I say? I'm bound to make mistakes.
It's like, well, we've done that before when we were driving through Arizona one time. We didn't have the 7-way pin plugged in.
Yeah, it sucks. It happens.
I feel like that happens to a lot of people on the road.
Absolutely.
So,
all right, let's head on over to Integra because it's only,
are you good?
A minute and a half down the road.
Okay. Oh, wow, there's another RV pulling in here. Here's the thing. Kyle said, let's give them a call when we're done here and see if they could sneak us in. My theory is always show your face somewhere rather than call. We do this with campgrounds and we try to do this in other scenarios wherever we can. What I mean by that is people are more likely to tell you, oh, we can't. I mean, they might be able to, but it's just easier over the phone to say no. Versus if you show up in person and you're like, can you help us out? People most likely are going to say yes and help you out. If they really can't do anything for you, then they'll tell you no. That's my thought. But if they can sneak you in and you're in person, then they will. Yeah, it keeps the honest people honest for sure. So that's just a little hint for you guys. Oh my gosh, the same thing happens with restaurants. I've noticed if you call a restaurant and you're like, hey, how long for a table? They always like say, oh, it's so crazy.
2-3 hours for a table, and then you show up and then they're like, 20 minutes. So we're gonna basically drive and show up to Integra Tire and see if they can get us in now instead of tomorrow morning.
Okay.
You're back.
We are back. They had to figure out, send all these messages up to their corporate office to make sure they actually had the tire, but they got it and they're like, yep, we'll take care of it right now. Let's get you in.
Wow, yes. That's great.
No having to wake up at 6 a.m. tomorrow. It's the small wins. That's what matters the most.
First come, first serve tire shops are a valuable resource for RVers during their journeys. Although it was incredibly busy at Integra Tire, the staff remained super professional and managed to meet our needs. Now, as Renee suggested, approaching businesses in person yields better results compared to phone inquiries, as it is easier for businesses to decline customers over the phone. When it comes to finding the specific tire you need, the biggest concern is ensuring its availability. Before heading to a dealership or a store, it is beneficial to make a quick call and confirm if they have your desired tire in stock. If no one has it available, start comparing prices. Call around to different businesses and place your order as soon as possible. Keep in mind that shipping can potentially disrupt your plans, so it's important to act promptly.
Woo! And just like that, we're done. So we do not have to wake up early tomorrow morning to come back here for first come, first serve. Oh my gosh, I just dropped my phone. Hitching up the RV once during the week to get work done on it is painful enough, let alone 2 days in a row. So I'm so glad we got it all figured out today. There's been a lot of RVs pulling in, and at first I thought they were here for tire issues as well, but then I discovered there's a dump station and a water fill station on top of propane refill and regular gasoline diesel, all in the same area. Like, there's campers coming in and out of here to dump their tanks and get water. But how cool is that, that you can pull into this area and it's a one-stop shop for everything? Thank you so much, Integra Tire. You're the best. Kyle's putting the spare back underneath, and I'm just sitting here with Stinky Butt, staying nice and warm. Yes, I know it's early September, it's still summer, but it's kind of chilly here. It's low 60s. What am I gonna do? What am I supposed to do?
Brakes, check. Tire replacement, check. Now, there are two more critical repairs we need to address, and it's crucial that you pay attention.
Typically, when we think of RV parts, our minds immediately go to dealerships for those replacement parts. But here's where we want you to think outside the box. If you're in Canada, you absolutely must check out Canadian Tire. It's like a Walmart on steroids.
Their RV selection is really nice here, much more impressive than going to Walmart. I guess you'd have to go to like Camping World to get this many RV supplies.
Canadian Tire is where it's at.
Mm-hmm. They have these.
Oh, that's cool. We should definitely get that.
Okay. Look at all the stuff we're getting now.
Canadian Tire is going to take all of our money.
They offer a wide range of RV spare parts, accessories, and much more. Notably, we found the exact same diameter valve for our freshwater tank supply there. When our tire blew out, it exposed the plywood underneath our kitchen slide. Since there was little covering to begin with, our top priority was to protect the area from water exposure. Remember, don't overthink and stress the repairs. Find what you need to get you back safely on the road. A huge recommendation is to look for a product called Eternabond. It's an amazing heavy-duty sealant tape that can be used on your RV roof or underbelly to prevent water damage. A roll of Eternabond is going to run you about $17 to $20. We recommend always having a roll on hand in case you get any tears in your roof. This is a temporary option for roof tears and ensuring that no water damage takes place. As far as the blowout spot, we may not even get this officially addressed. The Eternabond has continued to hold strong through our travels. It might not look great, but boy, does it get the job done.
Replacing our freshwater tank was a breeze. The new part, which we purchased from Canadian Tire, came with nuts, bolts, and a fresh gasket. I mean, what more could you ask for? Working together, we completed this replacement in under 10 minutes. It's worth mentioning that the new valve has a shorter rod than the previous one.
That was a pretty easy fix. Actually, I like this valve better than the one that came with it.
Why?
Because when that slide is in, you can't pull. That valve gets stuck on the slide, and I'm sure anyone else who has the same model as us runs into the same issue.
Oh, it was too long of like a rod.
Yeah, the rod, like, it's probably nice because you can reach it easier, but it hits the slide out.
Just for reference, here's that rod we were talking about that Renee was speaking of before, where it was like a longer pulley system.
So now we don't have to worry about sliding the slide out in order to drain the actual freshwater tank. It's much shorter. We could just reach under there and have quick access. So this is kind of like a blessing in disguise kind of thing. Yeah, pretty interesting how much damage a blowout can do. Just the power behind it is just incredible. This used to be straight and just, look at that. That's not normal. I know that this is a lot to take in, so thanks for all your patience. We're finally here and I'm ready to give you the full breakdown of all the costs that we incurred throughout this video. Note that these are all going to be listed in United States dollars. Also, if you need quick access to any of these items, you can find them in the video description. For the trailer brake system rewiring, it was $111.19. The trailer tire replacement was $157.87. A roll of Eternabond ran us about $20, but note that the pricing may vary based on the size and manufacturer. Last but not least, an inch and a half waste valve from Canadian Tire was $20.27. The grand total for all these expenses was $309.33. Considering the minimal time and cost involved, just one day and a little over $300, we strongly suggest advocating for yourself instead of relying on dealerships. Typically, dealerships take months to accommodate you and charge a premium price for their services. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe. We release new videos every single Thursday, and wow, do we have a library of videos for you to catch up on. If you want to see the tire blowout, we'll leave that video here, as well as a playlist to get you started on some of our other RV videos. We love and appreciate you all. See you next Thursday.